Hello. So today I'm going to show you how to fly various vehicles in the test pilot's world. These are going to be just short, simple ones for each different type of vehicle. If you want more in-depth ones, maybe I'll get to that point. But for now, I'm just going to go over each individual one, and we'll just go ahead and start off. First thing to know, when you're in these kinds of worlds that requires you to like manipulate controls and stuff, it's probably good to have an avatar that's their appropriate size. This world's not so bad with it, but I like to have an avatar that's more appropriate size. So this is about the normal height for an avatar. So yeah, let's go ahead and jump into it. I want to show you my favorite first, and that's the helicopters. So let's go. Whee! Actually, before I get to that, if you're new to this world, and there's a lot of flight worlds like this, there is an avatar flight system. So I can fly around without actually being in a plane or anything. And the way it works is if you use your triggers on your controllers, your right hand, this is my right hand, will fly you forward in any direction that you point, and then your left hand just flies you straight up. So the only way, or the only thing to know, is you have to be off the ground first before they work. So jump, and then pull the trigger. So I'm going to jump, pull my trigger. And now I'm flying any direction I point. Okay? It's buggy. anyway, so yeah, that's how you can get around the world a lot faster. A lot of people don't know that. And if you're on desktop, I'm pretty sure the controllers are space for up and F for forward, or whatever, which way you're pointing. So in case you're in a desktop mode. So yeah, let's go ahead and jump on into it. First thing to know about the helicopters is the pilot seat is on the right-hand side of the vehicle. So approach the right seat to get in. Oh, you're way up there. I'm going to actually close my camera. And we'll do this in first person. So the first thing I did when I got in the helicopter is I actually closed the canopy because this world is a little bit loud if you don't have the canopies closed. And I'll get to that in just a second on how to do that. But so the first thing to know, and this will be the same with all the other vehicles for the most part, is your HUD and these. Okay, so your HUD, let's see, you look at my left eye, I'm pretty sure. Actually, let me look real quick on my screen. Yeah, that looks like it's the left eye. Anyway, so you've got it's going to be your, actually, is that speed? Yeah. So your altitude over here. So is that the altitude? Or yeah? Yeah, no, I guess it must be. Anyway, so that's your altitude, and then your altitude change rate. So it'll be positive if you're going up in air, or, you know, you're getting altitude. It'll be negative if you're going negative if you're going down. Then your airspeed, pretty sure it's in knots. So I don't remember what's under that one. Give me a minute when I start flying, maybe I'll remember what the number under the box number is. Anyway, and then different numbers for, you got your Mach speed, which is just, Mach is, if you're going Mach 1, you're breaking the sound barrier. You're going 1 times the sound barrier. So your Mach speed, your G's. So as I'm standing here, we're pulling 1G, because that is the Earth's natural gravity, is just 1G. So if that goes up, that means you're pulling more weight. It's not really relevant to flying these, because obviously it doesn't, but it does get to on the jets. So anyway, that's your G meter. The number underneath the G, was just kind of blank there, is your max G that you've pulled so far. So keep that in mind. And then you got your armament. So you got air-to-air missiles, air-to-ground missiles. This one's got rocket pods, so the 36 little tiny missiles down there. Little target one with a bar. That's your gun ammo. So it doesn't say exactly how many rounds you have. It's just a bar indicating how much you have. And then some useful information. You've got this bar, which shows your throttle, and this four squares thing, which shows you the position of your yoke. Okay. And then the star with the 60, that is your flares. And then obviously your HP. And then you have your bearing. So that's the numbers across the top here. It says, you know, it goes from like 200 to whatever. It goes from 0 to 360s. Or, well, technically 360. But anyway, so it just tells you which direction you're facing in the world. Kind of like a compass. And then these numbers you've got. So it's like 5, 10, 15, whatever, all those. That's telling you your angle of your aircraft as far as this direction, basically. It'll change as you move around, and you'll see how that all works. And then you've got these little notches on the sides here, or on the... Sorry, I'm looking the wrong eye, so I'm not pointing properly. These little notches here, that just tells you your angle this way. So, anyway, that's all your HUD. Then you have these two things down here. This is going to be just your interactables. That's not just the main throttle and yoke. So the way you work these is you use your joysticks to point at things. So if I use my right joystick and push it up, you'll see I'm highlighting gun. Okay. And then if I move it around, I highlight different things. So that's how you select it. And then to activate it, you pull the trigger. So you can see I just shot my main gun. And so that's what I did when I first got in. I got to that canopy. So I select canopy and I clicked just so the canopy would close and the helicopter isn't so damn loud. Okay. So that's basically everything. First thing in a helicopter you need to know is, like I said, closed canopy. And that's all. Blade tilt is a thing, but it's really not needed. Blade tilt's more of, from what I know, I'm not a pilot in real life by any means, but blade tilt, from what I know, it seems like it would just help you in taxiing and be more comfortable to fly. But in VR, that's not, at least in this world, that's not really needed. So let's just go ahead and get down to that. Oh, and then, sorry, I forgot to tell you, there is a fuel. You have to make sure to watch your fuel. It lasts for quite a while, but eventually if you're flying around for a long time, you will run out. And you can come to the all the spots where the planes are and stuff, and you land here, it will refuel you as well as rearm and repair you. So keep that in mind. Anyway, so the most complicated control here is the yoke. The yoke and the joystick, you can grab without actually physically grabbing the model here. You can grab up here, and you see I'm still manipulating it. Or you can grab the throttle all the way out here. So you don't have to physically grab these, as long as you grip, okay? So you grip these two objects. You use your grip buttons on your controllers, okay? So the yoke is the more complicated one. When you grab it, you're going to have... hard to explain. You're going to have a few different ways you change it. First thing to know is you're not moving like this. You're moving like this. Okay. So think of it. You've got like a pivot on the bottom of your controller and you're pivoting it in place. All right. In some planes and some helicopters and stuff, not in this world, but in real life, you move your whole arm around like this. In this one, it's more of a fighter pilot kind of mode where you've just got these small little tiny movements. That's how generally fighter pilots and stuff are. Even though you would think with this huge bar that you would do this, you don't. Because like if you see me grab it and try doing that, nothing happens. It's when I start tilting my hand is when it starts moving. Okay. So the first thing to know is you've got your pitch. So if you look at my four square thing here, you see that little X that moves around? That is the yoke's movement. So that tells you exactly what you're doing with your yoke. You can look down and see, but it's better just to use your HUD. So if you pull back like this, if you pitch your hand backward, you can see that the pitch goes backward and then forward. So you've got pitch, yaw. So this is like, imagine my hand is the plane. So pitch, yaw, and roll. Okay. So this is pitch. I'll go straight to roll real quick. This is roll. Okay. So pitch, roll, and then to yaw, it's a little bit different. People don't actually always even know how to do it. You actually twist your hand. So you see that bar. When I twist my hand this way, that vertical bar tells you how much you're yawing. If you look at my hand, that's like this. So yawing that way. And when I'm sitting in the helicopter, it actually turns in place because that's how it works. And like that. So in real life, you'd actually use your feet. That's what these things are for. But in VRChat, obviously, you don't have necessarily feet, and so you use this. And if you're on desktop, all those controllers are over there. I don't play on desktop, so. Anyway, so there you go. That's the yoke, or flight stick, whatever you want to call it. It's a little bit complicated, and it's very sensitive, especially in the helicopters, so be gentle. Be very gentle with these, okay? And then you've got your throttle. The throttle, the only thing it really does... Sorry, it's technically throttle and collective on the helicopters all in one. In reality, they would be kind of separate, but really, it doesn't need to be that technical in VRChat. So all you have to do is just grab it and pull up. You can see that we start taking off. And you'll see that bar over here, that bar will start to rise as I pull up on the throttle. All right, so we're going to get into flying a little bit here. you'll notice that I'm about half throttle, but the helicopter's not taking off. The helicopter really doesn't respond much until like three quarters throttle, okay? So keep that in mind. So I'm throttled about up, about three quarters, and now I'm starting to lift. When it comes to the helicopter, be really gentle on the controls. I am barely moving anything, and that's how I'm able to hover here. You'll see people, they'll get into this world, and they'll yank on the joystick, or the throttle, and they'll go fly up like this, and they'll quickly get out of control because they won't know what they're doing. If you want to actually properly fly, the first things they do in real life when you're learning how to fly a helicopter is they only allow you to go out like a foot or two off the ground. You go up about this high, and you learn how to hover. Okay? So I really recommend you do the same. But anyway, so now that we're flying, as I said, you got the yoke to pitch yaw and roll you, and that'll change the helicopter's orientation. But the way a helicopter flies is, let me just land and kind of go on the outside to kind of explain this. It's a little bit complicated, and this will get kind of technical, but if you understand this, this is at least how my brain works. If I understand how something works, I can understand how to manipulate it better. So I'm going to go ahead and get out, and you get out by pressing your top button on your left controller. So the way a helicopter works is you've got the rotor. The rotor is providing lift. If you think about it, it's just a force pushing you, or it's a force pushing down, which counter pushes you up, okay? So if you take your whole helicopter and you pitch it forward, well, if that force is pushing down and you're pushing up, that's no longer just keeping you hover. You're going to be using a forward momentum. It's going to push you forward, okay? It's the same with any direction you pitch. So let me get back in and I'll explain that. So if I start applying throttle and I just keep myself level, I'll just stay here for the most part. Now, if I start pitching forward really hard, and if I play a little bit more throttle so I don't run into the ground, I start moving forward because my thrust is not only pushing down, it's pushing backward too, which then pushes you forward. So the same idea works in all other orientations. So let me get pretty much stopped here again. If I'm just sitting here and then I cock myself or roll myself left, I'm going to start moving left. Okay? And because of that, you can move backward and at weird directions, like weird angles and stuff. You won't always be moving the direction you're facing. That's actually one of the best things about helicopters, is they don't move in the direction you face. Kind of a little bit different planes. So, but because of that, it can get people tripped up really quick on how to remain in control. Just generally, the way to get back to stopped, like, and stop moving, is point in the opposite direction. So point your rotor in the opposite direction you're moving. So right now I'm moving forward. In order to stop moving forward, I aim myself backward. And then we slowly stop. Okay? See how that works? So if I was to do the same, except at a weird angle, so we're going forward and right, I do back and left to stop us. Okay? And that's it. That's all there is to a helicopter. Keep in mind that when you do crazy maneuvers in a helicopter, it can become dangerous fast because, say, I'm flying up really hard right now just so I can get some altitude to show you. But if you were to flip upside down and you keep at full throttle, it's going to pull you down because that's how the blade, refer back to what I was saying earlier. It pulls you in that direction or pushes you. So if I go upside down, you can only do it for a moment before you need to flip right back up the other direction and, stop yourself from falling so fast. One way you can negate that, a little bit pro tip kind of here, is if you go upside down, cut your throttle completely. It'll give you more time to be able to be upside down and then flip back the other direction and apply throttle again to slow down. Okay? So that's the helicopter. That's pretty much everything you need to know. Now, the next few planes we're going to go over are going to be a little bit faster. The helicopter, I needed to explain a lot for you to understand a lot of this. So let me just jump in the next planes, and we'll just kind of pop right through all these planes real quick. So I'm going to show just the basic little tiny plane. If you're first, starting off, don't get in the helicopter. If you've never been in this world, the helicopter is actually quite hard to fly for a beginner. So the first thing you want to fly is maybe this one, because this is pretty simple. So this one, I forget. I think you need to be on the right one. Yeah. So get on the right seat on the little plane. I'm going to close the canopy so you know how to work all that. This, for as far as planes, you're going to have things like landing gear and flaps. This one only has flaps. This doesn't have landing gear that you can retract. If you actually look down here, if I can pull myself out a little bit, this landing gear is actually solid, so you can't pull the landing gear on this one. Anyway, so very much similar stuff with this controls and everything. You can see my little tiny HUD here. The throttle is here, so I'm just going to throttle up. I'm going to taxi out onto the runway. And then line myself up in full throttle. You want to get yourself, especially with this plane, you want to get yourself quite a bit of a distance to be able to get up, because this plane is slow and it takes off at a high speed. I don't know. It's relative to its top speed. It's really quite high. So anyway, we're about 100 knots now. I'm going to pull back on the joystick so I can pitch up a little bit, and that's how you start flying. Now, with planes, with the helicopter, you, as I was saying, whatever direction you point with your collective or your blades is going to be the direction you travel in. Obviously, with a plane, you go forward because the propeller is pulling you forward, and your wings provide you lift. So when you start going forward, if you get enough speed, your wings will lift you off the ground, and you are now flying. If you start slowing down too much, so if I had to cut throttle right now, we're at 120 knots right now, but if we were to slow down enough, I'm not going to get enough airspeed over my wings, and I'm going to start plummeting. Even if I pull back on my yoke here, I can't do much, and now I'm stalling. Stalling means that you're going too slow for the aircraft to keep flying normally. You can get out of a stall by bringing your speed back up, like I just did. I just applied full throttle and got my speed back up, but just keep that in mind. So, also know that once we get into the jets, I might forget to tell you, but the jets have an afterburner. So what it is you'll get up to full throttle, and then if you slam the full throttle, it'll apply more power, or what's called afterburner, but it'll use a lot more fuel really quick. So that's how you can get extra speed with those. Anyway, so yeah, now we're flying. Same general controls with the yoke. So I'm rolling, pitching, and yaw. Yaw is kind of weird in this plane. It doesn't do a whole lot of yaw. Anyway, so and that's this plane. That's all there is to this one. This one's pretty simple. It's got flares, so you can, you know, let out your flares. It's got an air brake along with a brake. Actually, I don't know if it even has an air brake. I know it's got a brake for the wheels. I don't know if it has an air brake, but and then smoke. All the other planes have that same stuff. So I'm going to jump out and get in another plane. Okay. Let's get in to a jet. Now, with the jets, I'm just going to get into this one, but they're all pretty much the exact same. Close that, because that's loud. Before you go to take off, just know that there's a few things here. Obviously, canopy. I always close canopy when I get in these planes. There's going to be this thing called flight limit, or FLT limit. When you're first learning how to fly, don't mess with that. when you get to the point where you're more comfortable with flying, you can disable that. What it does is it doesn't allow you to do really crazy maneuvers very easily. It limits your flight. So keep that on when you're learning. When you take it off, you can potentially blow up in midair because you'll do a dangerous maneuver that'll actually tear the plane apart. But yeah, just keep that in mind. So now with this one, what I'm going to do is I'm going to taxi out onto this other runway. I'm going to apply the brake a little bit here so I can slow down. That's just one of those other things to know, is you do have a brake. And with jets, they have an air brake, so you can even slow down in air without just... You can dump your throttle and then apply air brake to slow down even faster. Anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and do just launch procedure, just throttle up. I'm not going to touch anything while I'm going forward. A lot of people will touch the yoke while they're going forward, and it'll end up kicking them in a weird way. Just wait till the aircraft gets off the runway or enabled to the point where you have enough speed to pull up. Either way. Anyway. So we're going 500 knots already. You can see this is much faster, and this is why this plane is a lot more enjoyable to fly than that little tiny prop plane. But once we're flying, you can see that we still have gear down and your flaps are enabled. So I want to disable both of those. You can keep them enabled, but it'll actually make you go slower, and it'll kind of ruin the performance of the plane a little bit. I'm also going to disable flight limiter because I don't need it. But yeah, so... Flying the jets are a little bit more enjoyable, but they're also a lot more nauseating, so just be prepared. First thing to note is you can see it on our Gs. I was talking about the G meter here. We've already hit 21 Gs there, and you might have heard it for a split second there. You will get a warning when you hit high Gs, and that's to tell you, you know, hey, you're stressing the aircraft quite a bit. That's that sound, that beep, 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 okay? There's three different sounds you'll hear. You'll hear that one. You'll hear another one, which happens at 40 Gs, which I don't know if I'll hit it without blowing up the plane. That more rapid-paced one, that one means that you're actively braking the plane. You can see now our HP has dropped a little bit because we overstressed the plane. Anything above 40 Gs is bad on the plane, so don't go over 40. Anyway, as I do it more. What else is there to know? Not really much other to know than that. Hook. Hook is a device to... So there's the aircraft carrier over here. On an aircraft carrier, they put cables out on the deck, and you use your hook to hook on to that cable to slow you down faster. Because in real... You know, like, if you're trying to land on an aircraft carrier, they're really quite small, and they need to slow you down faster. Your plane can't slow down fast enough, so you have to use that hook to be able to do that. So here's the aircraft carrier. Do a quick little flyby. Then you got, like I said, flaps and gear. If you don't know what they do, flaps makes you more maneuverable, generally at slower speeds, and that's used to take off and land. Okay. And then gear is just your landing gear. It's just the wheels. You know, you apply landing, or you open your landing gear, put your landing gear down, means that you're letting your wheels come out of the fuselage and be able to be under your plane so you can land on them. And then you got smoke. I didn't really tell you what smoke does. It literally just applies smoke to your plane. So as we're flying around, I have it enabled now. If I was to turn around, you'll see that smoke. That's all smoke is. And you can change the color of it. So if I highlight it and move my hand around, you can change the color. So you can customize it so people know it's you. So you see the color changing over there. That's me changing the color of it. Oh God, I stalled. Oh no, oh no. Being a little too dramatic over here. Anyway. And then AAM is air-to-air missile, so that's used to shoot down other planes, and gun is just the normal, like, shooty pew-pew. So yeah, there we go. That's pretty much all. Oh, excuse me, let me respawn real quick, and then show you the catapult. And that will pretty much be the base, the end of jets. Close my canopy, because that's crazy loud. Okay, so catapult, you'll see these two things here, and then there's a couple actually over there, and there's a few different ones throughout the world. These are your catapults. They're technically only really a thing on aircraft carriers in real life, but they wanted to be fun and put them on these. So what they do is exactly what it sounds like. It catapults you. The way it works is it takes your front landing gear on the plane. Jump out real quick. It takes this landing gear, which is pretty much right below you, and it holds onto it and it launches you with that, okay? So what you need to do is you need to take this landing gear and put it in this position right here, right where these two little things are, okay? So you need to fly the plane up to, well, not fly the plane, but drive the plane up onto here. All right. So what I do is I line up mostly first and then push myself onto it, and it, there you go. You'll know you're on it because two things will happen. You'll snap on, and you won't have any control over anything generally anymore. And, well, I guess those are two things. You don't have control, and you snap on. But also, you'll hear the sound, and then you'll see this catapult will light up. So before, it wasn't lit up. What that means is this is how you activate the catapult. So I'm going to select it with my left trigger. Or, sorry, my left joystick. And then I'm going to go ahead and apply full throttle. And this is the afterburner thing I was telling you about. You got full throttle here, but if I was to slam it forward, you see on my throttle, it went yellow and it's full now. That's an afterburner. It applies a ton more thrust. So once it's full throttle, I can just turn off catapult and away we will go. There you go. It's an easier and quicker way to get up in altitude as far as those like angled ones. But in real life, they're just meant to get you going fast enough to get off an aircraft carrier. Without it, the jets can't fly fast enough, quick enough. I should say accelerate fast enough to get off the plane or the carrier. But yeah, there you go. Turn off the limiter. And so that's pretty much all there is to know about jets. Oh, there's altitude hold, but I don't ever use that. It's kind of like a cruise control, and there is cruise control. I don't ever use them, but it is as it sounds. Altitude hold will pitch you in a perfect position so you keep the same altitude that it's generally set to. And then cruise control keeps you at the same speed. That's it. I don't use them because I'd like to be actively in control of my own jet. I don't even know how to disable cruise. Cruise won't disable. No! Okay, anyway. So, I'm not going to go over every single vehicle here, but there is one more that I want to show you. Maybe two. Yeah, let's go over two more. So, we'll go over that one last. So, this one is a water-based aircraft. It's a little bit weird for most people to understand, but this one doesn't just take off like a runway. Because you're in water, especially because we're in a little tiny pool, basically, we're in like a swimming pool, you can't take off forward. So what you have to do is take off vertically. So this kind of is like a mix between a helicopter and a jet. The way you get that to work is, you'll see that here it has VTOL angle. What you do is you'll select that, but you don't just select it, you have to modify the selection. So just like the colors wheel, or the colors, the smoke color, you have to click and hold, and then move your hand forward and backward. And you can see on the HUD, it's got that like 0 to 90 thing, and that tells you the angle of your thrust. So 0 is pointing straight forward, 90 is pointing straight down. So set that to 90, and then give it full throttle. And you'll go up like a helicopter. And it controls very similar to a helicopter, but it's really sluggish because it's a big plane, not a helicopter. So once you get some altitude, what you want to do is use that VTOL angle again and start pushing that towards 0. You can just slam it forward and you'll start going forward real fast, but like if you want to be in a little bit more control, do a little bit more gradual so that way you don't just plummet out of the sky. So anyway, now I've got enough forward momentum, so you see that I was about 100 knots before I did that, and now we're just flying. So now it's just a normal plane. Cabin position is a really weird thing. If I click that, you'll see that we move. Oh. If I don't blow up. Let me get back into it real quick. Cabin position actually physically moves the cabin, and I'm not entirely sure why you'd want that. I think it was just a cool thing that they just made. But yeah, let me get back in real quick. So yeah, cabin position, if you watch relative, we're going forward and then up relative to the plane. So if I get out, whoops. Oh, it doesn't do it anymore. It went back to normal. If you were to look from the outside, the cabin would be up pretty much above this intake. It's pretty weird. Anyway, so yeah, that's that plane. You can land it on water, and it's fine. Any other planes, obviously, you hit the water, you're dead. So yeah, that's that weird seaplane thing. And that one for armament, it only has guns. It doesn't have missiles or anything. So it's, but it can take a lot of hits. It's just really defensive, I guess. Anyway, and then the last thing is Big Bertha here, the big bomber. So for this one you pretty much have to have the canopy down. You can't really fly it unless the canopy is down, because that's the HUD is applied to the canopy. So anyway, you have to have that down. So this one's pretty much just like all the other planes, except this one does have VTOL, which is weird, but it wouldn't in real life. Like this plane, no way. So like, what, I'll enable it real quick. But it's also really funky. So if like I set it to 90, I don't know if you can see it, but you can see our jets are now, here, let me play space out, are pointing straight down. So I could fly vertically. But the weird thing is this one, you can set it to 180 degrees out, which means they point backward. Those are backward right now. So like this, that's normal. And then you can point it backward. So you can fly this plane backward, which is kind of funny, it's one fun thing about it. It's pretty much the only thing I ever do in it, because everything else about it's kind of boring. Anyway, so full throttle. All you have to do is just go straight. Don't touch this yet. When you first get in, just go full throttle, because you're already lined up on the runway. If you go a little bit left or a little bit right, you're going to hit something, because this thing's huge. So yeah, just go to the point where you're flying, then disable flaps and gear. There you go, you're flying. And the whole point of this thing is to drop bombs. So if I select bomb, you'll see a bomb bay will open. It'll show you a little target thing, and then I can just start dropping the bombs, and you can see they're falling down. That's it. That's this thing. It's kind of cool because it is so big, you can like impress people with it if you're really good at flying. And then for smoke, it's got two smoke trails, so they come off the wings there. You can see that I've got two smoke trails coming off the back of it. So kind of cool in that regard. Other than that, it's a little bit boring. And then I think that's basically it. There's this thing, which I haven't really flown much of yet. It's kind of weird. It's like a hovercraft thing. I guess I'll just show it to you real quick. So you get in and it starts hovering, and then you can fly it, but you have to deploy wings to do so. Like, you can do it without deploying wings, but it doesn't respond well. Like, you need the wings out to really do a lot of that. If you watch the wings come out, it's kind of cool. And it's got a headlight and flares, and it only has just a regular gun. So, it's interesting for sure, but it's weird at best. Just know that this thing is not meant to fly with, like, it's got afterburner, so, like, I'm at full throttle right now, but I can kick in afterburner, and I can take off, like, almost immediately, but this thing will burn through fuel like crazy with afterburner. You can only have the afterburner on for, like, a minute or two before it's completely out of fuel, so just keep that in mind. I haven't flown this thing enough to really be able to tell you exactly how to fly it very well. You can kind of see what I'm doing and then just toy with it, I guess. It's kind of like, it really is like a jet, but it kind of, I don't know how to explain it. It's nothing like real life. There's nothing like this in real life. So it's really hard to explain. It's definitely fun, but it's not super armored. So anyway, yeah, that's this thing. I don't even know what to call it. Like I said, hovercraft, hover jet thing, whatever. Anyway, so that's the video. There are a few more things about this world, but I'll let you explore and find those. If I went over everything, obviously it would be a freaking long video. This already is pretty dang long. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments. I don't watch this channel a whole lot. Like, I'm not super attentive to it, so I may not get around to it, but I might. And maybe I'll see you in the worlds or whatnot. I'll run into you, and if you have any questions, you can ask me there. But practice. The helicopters are hard to fly, but when you get good with them, oh my gosh, they are so fun. Yeah, have fun. Oh well, I guess I could go over this. I'll just do it real quick. I got a minute. So this is a turret. I think they call it a phalanx or something like that. I forget what they call them, but I think in real life they're quite a bit smaller and they're autonomous. They don't have someone to actually sitting inside of them. Anyway, to get in it, the seat is right here. It's in a good spot, but it's right up the very top of the stairs. So you get in here, and as you see, as I get in, it actually shoots the gun. But it uses the same kind of control for the most part as the planes. So, like, you can yaw and pitch. You can't roll, obviously. That'd be weird. But so, yeah. And then you can turn around and shoot things and stuff. But it gives you a reticle, just like it would in the planes. And it can tell you where to shoot things. So I'm shooting that target way the heck out here. I think I missed. Anyway, oh, I hit it. Hey, I don't know if you could even see that, but anyway, so yeah, you can shoot things with this. The thing is, though, I come to these worlds to fly, and a lot of other people do too. Using this is you're gonna make enemies. Like, people don't like the turret, and they don't like people who use it very often. So I would recommend not doing this. The only time I would say do this is if someone's really like not gonna be your friend anyway. Sure, whatever, use it. Or if, like, they're already friends with you and they know that you're just gonna use it and just to screw with them or whatever, because you can use this to shoot the helicopters down before they even have a chance to fly. It's kind of dumb. You'll see some people, they'll get in the helicopter and they'll just turn before they even take off and then shoot that, because they can't, the aim of this can't hit the helicopters, because it can't aim down. So I'm shooting right over the top of the helicopter. So what the helicopters will do is, as I said, they'll pivot in place and then turn and shoot it before they can even take off, because they hate it that much. You go to take off and that stupid turret shoots you down immediately. Anyway. Oh yeah, one last thing. There is tracks here, so you can, like, do laps on, I guess you just say races, as it says. What you do is you come over here and you press this button, and as you press it, these big old gates will spawn in the world. And let me get in this plane real quick. Once you get in a vehicle, you'll see that thing now has particles coming off of it. That tells you which gate it is. So this is the first gate, and it's blue. The next gate, this arrow tells you where the next gate is. It's down. As I get out, the particle system will turn off. But next gate is down here, and the next gate will be green. Is it green or yellow? I don't remember, actually. Anyway, so the first gate's blue, and then every gate after that will be green or yellow or whatever color it is. And then you just fly through them, and eventually you'll do a lap, and I'll tell you your lap time. Not a lot of people I know that do that, but it's a thing. So yeah, there you go. I will make another video here soon, probably right after this, about how to land and do a little bit more special maneuvers. This was just kind of general how to use video. So if you want to watch that, look out for it. It'll be coming on. All right. Adios.